Hello, dear friends. Each artwork begins from a start point, from original point. Just this moment you can see the origin point of my today's watercolor in my sketchbook. And my today's watercolor will be named Miracle of the Sunshine, Sky and Clouds. A few words about the video. I recorded this video one frame, without stops, without any changes of viewpoint, and in this respect some my working instruments like my brushes, my paints will be out of the frame. And now you can see my first trying to put a color point on the beautiful white surface of the paper. These first strokes are very important for me, at least for me, because they allow me to well understand the tonal and color balance, at least in the mid-tones, and to more well understand what I need to do on the next steps, deep of tonal contrast I need in different parts of my paper, because each artist have an idea and have any prognostic view. Each artist must to see by his inner viewing what result will be on a paper, and must correct his actions during the process. Now you can see a slightly difference between two colors that I already put on the paper. You can see more warm and more cold colors, and I have to say that color mixes made from the same three colors. That colors are one yellow, one purple and one blue. This mix, like trident, color trident, allow me to have possibility exit to more clear colors if it need. And now you can see I try to fix any small mistakes on the edges of color areas, and I put any more deep variations into color brush strokes. I try to use not very wet brush. Usually my brush is almost dry. Try to keep my shining parts of clouds as clear white surface, especially like clear white surface, because next I can to cover it with a slightly layer of any color. But on the first stage of my painting process I need to have these color areas in relation to white surfaces of paper like camera tone, because my next steps will be linked with more deep tonal contrast, with more intensive colors, and this first stage is, I repeat, is very important for me. I make more wetness of color surface with a spray of clear water if need to avoid very very hard borders between colors. As you can see, my surface of paper is almost dry. Sorry, my head in the screen. It's only a moment. And time to time I coming back to keeping the edges of color areas wet, very slightly wet, to avoid, as I said, very hard borders. And if I need to input more dark or more intensive color, I do it. And with a small brush, I can to take off extra volume of color on any part, and you can see mid tones of future clouds. Time to time I will come back to shining parts of the clouds. Few words about my paper. I paint this watercolor on the arches of watercolor, 300 grams. My paper based on a plain plastic board, absolutely plain, and my paper has very wet backside, and I started when the front side of my paper was almost dry, with very low percent of humidity. The condition, the well condition to the start of painting process, at least for me, is when the paper is not have any reflections of water on the surface. When the paper is cool, and when the drop of color not spread very wide, and when I can to draw small line with a almost dry brush without any spreading. It's good for me, but maybe not so good for another artist, but it's my way, and it's very comfortable for me, not for all steps, but for acceptable to me level of control for colors, for wetness, and for possibility to continue the process in any part of my paper. As you can see now, I try to input different variations of colors into already covered parts, and in this color mix a bit more purple color, as I said previously, that in my color mix Hinacridone Relac. Now I draw this wet brush the silhouette of light cloud like foreground for the big cloud behind. I use many brushes. My brushes set, and the most important aspect for me in view of brush condition, when I find the brush is acceptable and comfortable for me, good balance between the elasticity and softness of brush hair. I use both the Asian and European type of brush and natural and synthetic hair, and I have many very good findings, and my working brush set grow. Now I continue to forming my cloud. Usually the first part of cloud painting is more long in relation to final parts, because in the first part I very attentively look for all sides of color, tonal balance, and try to avoid any not acceptable for me places on paper surface. Now the time to prepare apply more dark and more intensive cold color, as you see that almost clear in Danton blue. And now I will try to mix directly in place this color with previously applied. It allow me to make more smooth bridge between warm and cold colors, and to make visibility of volume of cloud. I use squirrel brush. My area of more cold blue color is wet, and I continue to forming my cloud. I have to say the angle of my board is very small, maybe 10 or 15 degree to horizontal line, and I like to paint using the photographic tripod. It allow me to rotate to make comfortable for me angle of paper with a base, with a plastic base, and to keep a good balance of wetness and softness in each place of paper. As you see, I can still can possibility to repair and fix small mistakes, to repair any places with hard borders, to make it more soft. And now I will I will put more cold color to previously applied layers of paint. During this process is a very nice possibility to thinking about the subject of my painting. Very nice time and very nice possibility to call up the images of what I saw previously, and that images that gave me an impression and to think about making a mix between my visual memory, visual representations, my imagination, and to try some improvisation in my work. I thinking about it, it seems to me these three things are very important to each artist, not only to watercolor artist, because each watercolor artist, first of all, is artist, and all that we want to express in our works, all that we can to depict, all the things we see, either directly with our eyes or with inner gaze, and the good balance between the remembrance, visual imagination and improvisation is a very, very important instrument to each artist. You can see on the screen I make the very small fixing of color tone, and now I make more wet down part of area of cloud. And next, my thinking about the subject of today's watercolor and about the watercolor process. Now I continue to input more clear blue colors, and as I did previously, I try to mix newly applied strokes with the previously applied layers. I do this because the painting process, when a paper is wet, even slightly wet, give the result more light than seems when you put color on a paper. After some minutes, your paints looks more light, the contrast more low level of contrast, and when you paint by this way, you need very big attention to all parts of your paper. Now I try to make in form as two small clouds in left high part, and to make more deep and more intense color. Very hard to to keep the good balance not only between colors, between tonal part of painting. Very hard task to keep the good acceptable balance between small details and parts of painting that made by very wide bold brush. And now I try to keep the wetness of my paper. And additionally, I use the possibility to take out some parts of color color from the paper with clear elastic brush to keep highlights on the shining parts of clouds. This process very long and very meditative. In addition, watercolor, if you try to paint to the limit, to all your forces, is a good test for these forces, good test for strength. But at the same time, it's a good vacation. It's a vacation that has little to compare with. Once, many years ago, I make subtitle to my site, and I write in this word about watercolor, that watercolor for me is a test of forces, of my forces, excitement and good relaxation. And up to this time I keep this these things about watercolor and watercolor painting process. So now is time to make preparation for painting the clear sky space. Skies over my clouds. This allow me to show shining edges of clouds, and I make the color mix from Indian blue and cerulean blue without without any wrong colors. The top right corner of my paper is almost dry, and using the elastic flat brush allow me to make very specific covering with small white parts in strokes like drawing. Now I try to make acceptable silhouette with keeping white part of clouds, and I try to make sky space like a gradient from mid tone to almost white directly near the right corner of my paper. I use elastic hair brush. My flat brush have hair of ox, and allow me to draw with a almost dry brush. When I see the tonal contrast is extra, I can use the spray to make coloring more smooth. And to making this my gradient more acceptable for my imagination. And now the time to prepare a color for background clouds on near the horizon in the middle part of my paper will be far distant clouds. Now the moment when I need to take off from color areas extra volume of water, and I can to make it with a flat brush, with the elastic hair flat brush. It allow me to also to repair some parts of clouds and make more white parts on a cloud volume. For the far distant clouds, I will use again the color mix that I use firstly when I started. And this color mix, as I said previously, include golden deep, part of Hinacridone lilac, and a bit of Indantron blue, and on the next steps I will input to this color mix directly on place. I will input more cold color using the Indantron blue and maybe a bit of cerulean, or maybe a bit of maybe cobalt or a bit of ultramarine. At the same time, I start to making part of white silhouette of big cloud on a foreground, and the limit of body of this cloud is the background wall of clouds near the horizon. I try to keep many clearly white parts time to time big, time to time small, on all parts of my painting. And now I try to input cold colors to down parts of far distant clouds. And to make a good, acceptable for me silhouette of each part. time to time I use fingers, touching of my fingers, because it also the instrument of artist. And now I mix it more in Danton Blue and more Hinacridone Lilac. And begin to forming the silhouette silhouettes of far distant cloud, and at the same time the cloud, big white cloud on the middle part of my painting. Now I use a very nice flat brush. That brush maybe 20 years old, and I don't know where I can find the same. Now I forming the far distant clouds silhouette with my very soft squirrel brush and my fingers. As you can see now, the image of top part of cloud is almost ready, and I can to draw with my wet brush middle, the main part of my painting, where, as I said, will be great white cloud, making more wet the down part of color area. And now I need more dark and more intensive cold color on my brush to make expressive silhouette of main white cloud. I not use photo, I use my remembrance, imagination, and my sketch that you can see at the start of my today's session. On this way I can face the success, and maybe time to time this process can be not successful, but I hope this process will be successful. My very soft brush allow me to make as wet touching as well touching like dry brush, and then I make the wetness level is more high with my spray. Now, after some touching of my brush, I can see more clearly, directly with my eyes, what silhouettes, what forms of my clouds, not only in my mind, and I can to correct and to judge my own composition. It not so difficult, but time to time appeared the hard moments. I try to avoid some mistakes. And now I understand that my paper on the backside is not so good in view of humidity level, and I have to make it more wet with my very big flat brush. The good indicator of wetness is the behavior of corners of paper. When I see my paper corners take from the base plastic board, I understand that wetness of my paper is low. Now you can saw that I use big flat brush, almost dry brush, to make very light structure of a big white cloud. Sorry, my head between the camera and my paper, only for a minute. And as you can saw, I can to control wetness, or maybe drops falling to the paper with a napkin, with a paper napkin. And now I again use my very elastic ox brush to make a good form, and mid-tone part of big white cloud on the foreground. It's very, very light touching of almost dry brush, and time to time making more wetness with a spray. It's a good process, but need very high level of attention to all parts, because some levels of colors was applied enough long time ago, and borders can be dried. And now I can to fix some small mistakes, to fix any parts of cloud silhouette. And again I take my very elastic and soft flat brush to make a linear drawing. I take off parts, small parts of color, to make flying, small flying clouds, and I can to make smooth parts of this big white cloud. Now horizon is more closely to my hand, and I make some difference in my color mixing. I make more in natural blue and a bit more Hinacridone Lilac. The colors in this part, in mid part of painting, more dark, more intensive, and in comparing with the top part of my picture, appeared, the more strong contrast. It's my goal to reach the goal of showing difference between shining part of cloud and shadow part of clouds. And now I continue to make a form of my clouds. It's almost unlimited process, but time is growing and down parts of cloud and horizon is more closely. Now fixing small details. And now the time to form down parts of far distant cloud and part of my cloudy sky around the main cloud on the foreground. As previously, I use a very elastic flat brush and trying to make form of the clouds with very free and speed moving of my brush without very attentively working on the small details. I take out extra wet, extra wet parts of color coloring. So now the moment to thinking about down parts of clouds, down part of foreground white cloud, down parts of far distant clouds near the horizon, and this step not so difficult, but it can be difficult for many because it strictly need to turn on your imagination.
You have to imagine. You have to imagine the flight over the surface of Earth or maybe sea surface and under the down parts of clouds. Very interesting and very useful experience can be in airplanes during the flight, or maybe if you on the any high part, high building, view place, or maybe high bridge. It's a very good experience to see and to find and to compare the places on Earth or sea surface that covered by shadow with the parts covered by sunlight and plain sun rays, and compare the lightness and deep of shadow on a line of brightness. Imagine that you have inner your inner editor like Photoshop, and imagine that you have very precise instrument to measure the light intensity, and try to remember it. I remember one story about artist who tried to paint the sunlight on the end of the day red bright tape near the horizon, very bright and shining, and all his trying was not successful up to a moment when he wanted to smoke and take lightning, and only natural brightness of lightning gave him the true compassion and true balance between brightness of real light and possibility to depict this light on a white surface, independent with another colors of his work, artwork. Now, as you see, I am going to finish my down parts of clouds. Now the clouds are like a great wall in the sky, and I try to make in a good form with the acceptable for me relations of color and tonal moment between the high parts of this wall of clouds and down parts. Now, my brush and my hand closely to horizon, and I try to make the colors in this part having a slight variation in color and tone, and at the same time I continue to fix any small parts that not that looks not acceptable for me. I repairing some parts of my painting. And now the time to mark the line of the horizon. When you paint any scape, seascape, landscape, the horizon line is very important for all composition for all composition of your artwork, because the horizon line is basically depend of our point of view usually in our real life, and moreover that depend to impression of your painting, of your composition on canvas, on paper,
about what I say. Usually we look in direction a bit lower than horizon line, because we must to look before your legs, but the artistic view can be in direction to higher parts over the horizon, up to zenith of the sky, and as well artistic view can be directed to lower parts under the horizon, if it needs the composition idea of this artwork, and so on my paper the down part lower than horizon line about quarter of size of vertical size of my paper, that as I hope that gives me a specific view, that gives me a view like seeing with wide open eyes, and not to look directly before the viewer. Not usually I use this proportion of my painting composition. Time to time I use the high horizon in relation to down part of my paper. But this time, when the main subject of my painting is state of sky, state of clouds, and additionally part is reflection on a sea surface, I concentrate in middle of my painting the main part of show of my clouds, and you can see now I made the depiction of the shadow under the clouds, and sea surface I depicted almost without details, only the silhouette of shadow, and I try to make it more dark, not closely to edge of my paper, but closely to horizon line, because I want to concentrate my look and look of my viewers more closely to middle part of my composition. The color of this part also cool, but in this mix more part in proportion to the yellow deep, and I add to my color mix small volume of small volume of paints gray bluish. I use it to make more natural but at the same time cool color in comparing with a more clearly blue of down parts of clouds. I use my spray to make down part of sea surface more light, because drops of spray can taking off the small parts of color. And now I make not white with very slight covering, very slight, very thin covering part over the horizon. But now I see that my paper is enough wet, and now I dry it, slightly dry it, the line over the horizon, to avoid damage to the previously applied colors. Now, after drying, I can to cover the band between the clouds and horizon line with a very slightly warm transparent color. And with this instrument, I hope to concentrate attention on the clear white parts on the top of the cloud composition. And now you can see this mix with a very very light and transparent color of mix golden deep in the Hinacridone lilac and few drops of ruby red. Now I have all parts of my painting. I have a cloud wall with a shining parts and deep blue parts. I have surface under my clouds and silvery silvery strike on the horizon. And what I need to this session and end of my painting. In a seascape can be necessary any small detail that will be like a dark camertone, because light camertones we have in the high parts of my watercolor, that's shining edges. And traditionally for me, using the silhouette of ship, that's not about ships and navigation, that for me is the point of concentration. And point of concentration and returning the attention, your attention, from cloud composition to point of horizon. And like this point, I use the silhouette of ship. It's not special ship. It's usually transporter. That maybe that. Transfer bananas or maybe any very useful things from one part of our earth to next. But at the same time, for me, is a symbol of way, a symbol of traveling, symbol of traveling in our own mind, and the symbol and analogy with our way alone, the life. And on this point, I called to finish, but only also one thing need to me before the finish. What's this? This my symbol, my sign, and now I put this in the left down part, left down corner of my today's water car. And I have to say that this seance, this process was very enjoyable, and that I hope that successful for me.